go to the beach now about 2 times a week. Just walking, thinking, collecting material, drawing, writing. The northeast coast is particularly important in the development of my work because of it's where I came to university, and I just fell in love with it. I fell in love with the wilderness of it and the wildness of it. And very early on, I discovered this wall in a village on the Applecross Peninsula in northwest Scotland. It had this kind of presence about it, and so I started to want to go back every year, and I went back every year for 23 years. Each stone, because it was so round, it looked like a planet, and it had a kind of colony of lichen on it, which looked like a planet. And it started to just make these big links between looking at something small, but thinking about something big, and as vast as the universe. So it became very profound, and it started to kind of come across in the work. Out of just almost nothing, you could create something which would make you think about big subjects. I started a series when I would walk on a beach, and instead of picking up the beautiful stone or the beautiful shell, I would just put a handful of the beach in a bag and bring it home, and force myself to make an image out of nothing, just out of a handful of whatever was at my feet, challenging myself to make more complex pictures out of less obvious material. And then one day I brought back some seawater, and I started to then add the seawater onto negatives. You got a kind of stain or a kind of a bloom of salt crystals. In 2000, I found a message in a bottle, in a 7-Up, green 7-Up bottle. And it was a school project from an island off Newfoundland. And it had taken 7 years for this bottle to get across the Atlantic and onto this beach in Ireland. And as I was taking this message out of the bottle, I was looking at the bottle, and it had thousands and thousands of scratches on it. And it suddenly came to me in one moment that each scratch was kind of created by the landscape, by nature, lapse of the tide, year after year after year after year, making these thousands of scratches. And so that was the moment I started to cut bottles up and make prints from them. And then I started to add seawater to the plastic, and the whole sort of Seaworks series started from there, really. I've always thought of photography as a two-stage process. You make a negative, or you capture an image in some way, and then you make a print, and that's a second stage. And I think what I've done in my work is I've completely eliminated photography from the first stage, and I actually make what is in effect a still life. My arrangements that happen to be on a glass plate, using bits of old fishing line and rust. but it's kind of this first stage of the process. And then there's this photography process that comes in to capture the image. I have a collection of seawater from various beaches, various moments. And if I'm using material I know was collected on a particular beach, I'll use the seawater from that beach. It can take 2 weeks, it can take 2 months. Well, they would dry in kind of patterns and structures. I like this idea that it's just still life. It's just me gathering stuff in the landscape. I started to think about my work like a rope. Early on, this rope had very few threads to it. And as I've gone on, threads have added to it. So it's become more and more complex. The first motif to appear in the work was this idea of a circle in a black square. And that came directly from the wall. And that theme, that motif runs right through to the latest work. a bit later on, another motif comes in, which is this a kind of curved line that could be a horizon. A third motif is a kind of rectangle or square. I started to make these sort of rectangles and squares in the work that were kind of somehow indicative of man's effect on the landscape. There's an idea about the fragility of the landscape and man scratching at the edges of it. In 22 years of going back up to Scotland every year, I started to see things like more litter, more plastic. I want my pictures to be beautiful, but intriguing. And it's somewhere in the other intrigue, you might think about environmentalism. There's two main new threads. One of which is this idea of remixing. I started to think about using those negatives. The picture you took before, the picture you took after, the one that's out of focus, and incorporating them into the Seaworks series. So I started to cut negatives up and reassemble them. The other new thread in the rope is this idea of grids. Initially it came from grid lines on maps. As soon as you put a grid line on something, you immediately bring in ideas of man parceling land up, man trying to understand the land, measure it. I want my pictures to be deep, thought-provoking, to be beautiful.